James Cook, winner at round four, don't forget, so he will want to finish his season on a high. Battle for the lead, and that's Ross McGuire is down! Ross McGuire, the new champion, is down. His hand is in the air. What were you playing at?
Well, I'm not sure what Ross thought went on there, but I think Eddie O'Shea was past him when that incident happened. We'll get another look. Let's have a look at the slow motion. Ross is in the lead. Eddie comes round the outside. He's in front of him at that point. I think his knee just touches the front of his bike. And down goes the 2017 champion. And there's the recrimination. He's got his hand in the air, so to say, what went on there? They're getting him going again. He is going to get going, but he's well down the field.
There is the 48, making the move on the inside there. That is Alexander Page.
Oh, contact!
That is between the leaders, Hesketh and Strong. Hesketh and Strong have come together, and that's thrown it all up in the air.
And that suits Abby Pulling as well, because it moves her up a couple of places.
That
Here's
is
a move.
Strong trying up the inside of Hesketh, just got on the curbs, and there's nowhere for either of them to go after that point. Once you've got two wheels on the curbs, you're on a bucking Bronco. Three riders going for it, Hammer and Tongs, Mountsey, Crosby and Payne. It looks like Crosby might be trying to make a move. Oh, he's bailing out of it, he's hit the rear wheel of Mountsey. He goes wide, he's on the curbs, he's down, and Desai's got nowhere to go. Oh, disaster, both of them out of the last race of the season.
Well, you've got to feel sorry for Harrison Desai with nowhere to go, as you say, Jake. Looks down the inside, tries to bail out of it, hits the back wheel of Sullivan Mousey. Fortunately, doesn't take him off, but look, runs over a little bit of a wet patch, gets out onto the painted kerb, throws him off high side, and here comes Harrison Desai with nowhere to go.
Now he's having to cover the inside line to stop Ellingham coming around the outside. Greenhorse to his left, though, on the inside. James Walker gets in there as well and makes up a place. Oh, there's contact! That looks like we've got Block and Greenall both going off the circuit there. Disaster for Sebastian Block and for Oliver Greenall. Both of them having an absolutely cracking end to their season. Greenall up from 22nd, Block from the front row. Let's have a look at it again. There was three of them all trying to get in there. Four, in fact, as look, the O-plane of Ellingham tries to go on the inside of the 97 of Block. There's a little bit of a rub and there's nowhere for Block to go.
Battle this one. Bailey Stewart Campbell had some great results this year in the Mini GP 50. This is the best return
from Smart down.
Oh, what a signal for Finn Smart down in Sunny Bend. That's his race over. That's his 2017 season finish. You just see Emmanuel Brinton going through there.
And I think what that means as well, with Finn Smart going down, that almost guarantees Evan Belford second in the championship, because the next man is a long, long way back. He wouldn't drop to fifth. Look, that was because Johnson had to back out of the move on Bailey Stewart Campbell. And now Harry Thompson, what was that for? Banging his car.
Something not right on the car, he's not happy with.
Trying to get his move on Joe Taylor sorted out into the final couple of corners. Joe Taylor, oh, there was a little bit of contact and there's more contact. Harry Thompson goes off, Joe Taylor goes off. Now that all started down into the braking zone for the right-hander, and there's going to be two very different opinions about what happened there. I think Thompson is going to argue that maybe Joe Taylor braked too early to intentionally ram into him. I don't think Taylor's going to have the same viewpoint, but Taylor wins, Thompson wins the championship. Let's have a look at it again.
The point being though, Jake, Harry Thompson's already got a penalty, surely, for that earlier contact. So yeah. I'm not sure what the benefit to Joe Taylor would be.
Yeah, you'll have to make of that one what you will, guys. Ricky Flynn Motorsport team. There's a massive gap back to third. Cerinetti challenging for third. Contact! Oh, up in the air! Cerinetti rides over the top. And that is it. Game over for both him and Zane Maloney. Let's watch. Maloney gets sideways. They rub wheels. Airborne goes Cerinetti. And somehow everybody in the queue misses them. Will not be contesting the victory now. He's dropped too far back off this queue as they go into the Lynchfield Bridge. Bunce going for the move. He's hit his teammate. He's wiped him out. Oh, Bunce makes the move on Edmonds and he didn't expect him to be there. They have collided and it's game over for both of them. But the battle for fourth is still going down to the death and it's the last chance for Crockford and he knows it. Now he's got to give it a go. Up the inside. He's done it. Absolutely incredible. Crockford does it at the final turn.
Thanks for watching, guys. Check out more of our videos on the channel, over 500 to choose from, a selection of which are right here.